Hi, I'm Josh Wilson, and I wrote the song Before the Morning about my good friends Tim and Paula Beal, and I would love to share their story with you. Theirs is a story about the frailty of the human heart, a story about the struggles that we all face, but most of all, it's a story about hope.
God gave me my first job working with student ministry for a church in Lubbock. I was there for about 3 years, and then moved to a church right outside of Lubbock in Wolfworth, Texas. And was there for a little over four ministering, which is when this whole story kind of took place. Paul and I were married for 6 years, five years, whenever we had our daughter, Madison, who was beautiful. Beautiful blonde hair, blue eyes, loving life, came out just an amazing, healthy, beautiful, smart little girl. She had done great, man, turned three, and we found out that we were gonna have another baby. And we were going through getting ready for what was going to be hopefully our second child. And we went September 11th to find out what we were going to have. And that's kind of when our world kind of crashed. The doctor started sonogramming, and the nurse kind of got quiet and walked us out and moved us into a different room. And they told us that there was something that wasn't right. They said they thought it was because of how he was laying, but that they couldn't find part of his heart. It's called hypoplastic left heart syndrome. And so instead of having a four-chamber heart, he had two chambers, and the side that he had lots of problems. A lot of the valves hadn't formed. His kidneys and his lungs weren't functioning properly. And they immediately took us to a doctor that started suggesting that we have an abortion. And he told us that we would never be able to afford what was going to happen, and that even if we did, it would ruin our marriage because of the stress. And then he said that our son would never have a good quality of life. And I fell back on my faith because I knew I didn't want to kill this baby that God had given us. And if he was going to be this gift of God we had prayed for, we were going to wait and see what God was going to do through his life. We didn't know what to do, but I remember the God that saved me in seventh grade, and I remembered all the things that I'd learned. And Paula said something to me, and I don't even know if she remembers saying it, but she said, if we can trust God with our eternity, we've got to trust him with our now. And so we did. In January 11th, in Plano, our son was born. They wouldn't let us have him in Dallas, because they didn't think he was going to make it. We decided to name him Jacob David. We got Jacob from Old Testament. It's one of the pillars of Solomon's temple. And then we chose David because the meaning of the name is victory and grace through God's beloved. And we knew that he was loved by God and that we were going to receive victory and grace through his life somehow. The problem with what his condition, with hypoplastic babies, the heart doesn't put any oxygen in the blood. And so his body has blood, it just doesn't have oxygen, and so they slowly start to suffocate. They said that he would have a 2% chance to live past 4 days. So at 4 days old, they begin a surgery on his heart to try to build it, to do something that it wasn't gonna do on its own. They couldn't really put in the side that wasn't there. Kept telling us, you know, you may not take him home, but it's gonna be a long trip from here on out. I mean, I'd never seen so many machines. There was lights and cables. He was covered in stuff. But then he started to perk, and he started to open his eyes. And they were telling us to expect 3 months. And 14 days later, our doctor, who was a believer, walked in and said, man, we don't know what's going on, but you're going to take your son home today.